Let's see another term, that is absorption. We frequently use the word absorption. We rarely use the word adsorption. ADAB. See the spelling. AD, adsorption. Here AB. Both are not same. Let's see the definition for this absorption. It is the accumulation of particles of one substance in the bulk of another substance. Have you identified the difference between adsorption and absorption? Their accumulation of particles of one substance over the surface of another substance in the case of adsorption. Whereas in the absorption, particles of one substance accumulate or concentrate in the bulk of another substance. See the picture for adsorption. Picture for absorption. This is substance A. Inside particles of B. So this is the picture which explains absorption process. So here what happened? Into the bulk of substance A, the particles of B entered. But in adsorption, particles of B only concentrate on the surface. Here particles of B concentrate within the bulk of another substance. So this is absorption. You know, absorption is a bulk phenomenon. It is a bulk phenomenon. Whereas adsorption is surface phenomenon. Adsorption is surface phenomenon, but absorption is bulk phenomenon. Let's see some examples for absorption. See the first one. You know, anhydrous calcium chloride. What is that? Anhydrous calcium chloride, CaCl2, calcium chloride. It absorbs moisture from air. When you place anhydrous calcium chloride in a room, it simply decreases the humidity in that room. Why? Because it absorbs. Whereas the adsorption I discussed, that silica gel or alumina gel, that simply absorbs. Their adsorption, silica gel absorbs the moisture. Whereas anhydrous calcium chloride absorbs moisture from air. Second example. Absorption of H2 gas into powdered palladium, PD. PD means palladium. You know, it has a specific name, that is occlusion. Occlusion, absorption of H2 gas into powdered palladium is an example for occlusion. Okay, occlusion means it's a solution. Which solution? Gas in solid type solution it is. Third one, when a chalk piece is placed into ink bottle, when a piece of chalk is placed in ink bottle, what happens? You know, the solvent of ink goes into the bulk, whereas the particles of ink, that means colored particles, they are absorbed on the, what is that? Absorbed on the surface of chalk piece. So there occur two processes. So absorption of ink, solvent of ink into the bulk of chalk piece is an example for absorption. So absorption of solvent of ink into a piece of chalk. Absorption of solvent into solvent of ink into a piece of chalk is an example for absorption process. Okay, so here ink molecules, that means which are causing color, that colored dye in the ink is adsorbed, whereas solvent of ink is absorbed. Similarly, see one more example. Absorption of water. Absorption of water into a sponge. When a sponge is placed in water, it simply absorbs water. Okay, these are some examples for absorption process. So have you understood what is absorption? Here particles gather only in the bulk of substrates. Absorption is a bulk phenomenon, whereas adsorption is surface phenomenon. Got it? So this is about absorption.